Welcome to another edition of NASCAR America Splash and Go, presented by Coca-Cola with Parker Kligerman and Dale Jarrett. Okay, guys, I mean, the last couple of weeks, we had, what, Michael Jordan joining NASCAR, the 2021 schedule comes out. Now, Dale, the big news this week, a new driver moving over to basically the most successful car number in the modern era.
Yeah, gosh, what an act to follow. I've thought about this a long time as to who was going to go in that. Would they even keep the number 48 at Hendrick Motorsports and put someone in that position? And so now we know the news. They have a great sponsor there, Ally, that just came on a couple of years ago. They're going to be there through 2023. So this was more of a business decision than anything else. They have a great young driver in Alex Bowman. And before they put all the pieces in place at Hendrick Motorsports as to who the fourth driver may be coming along, I think they needed to make sure that they had this in line. And so Alex Bowman has done his work. He's done everything that's been asked of him at Hendrick Motorsports through the years, and has done a really good job on the racetrack. He's becoming a more seasoned driver, has himself in a great position to move into the round of eight here with just a solid run this weekend. So a lot of good things happening for him, but a lot of pressure that goes along with that number. But he's already accustomed to that. Gosh, I mean, he filled the shoes of going into the 88 car from Dale Earnhardt Jr. So I don't think he lets that affect him too much. But I think it's a really good fit for him and Ally to do this and to continue at Hendrick Motorsports.
Well said, Dale. I actually, I texted Alex yesterday when the news came out, and I said, congrats. And then I said, first you follow up the most popular driver in the sport, and now possibly the greatest of all time. Your book is going to be excellent. But and he laughed about it. But, you know, I think the thing that you alluded to there is that it wasn't just business, but also performance. You know, he wouldn't have had this opportunity if he didn't perform when he got in that 88 car. And then now getting given this opportunity in the 48 with Ally as a sponsor, a bit of job security. It wasn't but, what, a couple of months ago we were wondering what happens with Alex Bowman in that 88 and Hendrick Motorsports. So I think when you look at the 48 situation, though, you know, there's a belief out there, and there was a thought process that this was a ride reserved for Kyle Larson, right, until he had his incident. This was his ride. He was headed towards Hendrick Motorsports in the 48, replacing Jimmie Johnson. You know, Rick Hendricks has eye on Kyle Larson for a long time, and then he obviously had his issues. He's out of the sport now, so they had to find a way and a plan B in terms of, you know, how do we take care of this great sponsor and Ally that's committed to the sport and give them the best chance to go out there and win championships, and that's Alex Bowman. And I like what he said when he alluded to the fact of saying, look, last year when I got the 88, I was filling in for the most popular driver. I don't want to be the most popular driver. I want to win championships. I want to win races. So the 48 is a place where it's been done. I want to follow in that legacy. And I think that's a really cool thing for him.
Yeah, and I believe you brought up Kyle Larson there. And I still believe that's a real possibility. A little bit of speculation, I guess, maybe. But I think it's something that we'll hear pretty soon. Obviously, it was unfortunate with Kyle Larson. But if you haven't had the chance to read his letter that he wrote, very heartfelt and shows exactly everything that he's doing to rectify his situation and to try to satisfy everyone, especially NASCAR, to where he can get reinstated. But I believe that will happen. And he's becoming a better person for all of this. And sometimes these hard knocks that we have to take make us better people. I'm not going to say it's going to make him a better race car driver. He didn't need to be much better in that respect. But I think this is something that Rick Hendrick, NASCAR, and some sponsors along the way will look at and say, this young man deserves a second chance at this. You know, we are a world of second chances, and the United States, I think, does a great job of that, this great country that we live in, of looking back and saying, okay, you know, he's doing everything that he can to be a better person and to make this a better world and better country that we live in. So I believe that may happen along the way, and it would be good for the sport and great for Kyle Larson.
Yeah, I think too, you know, in these times, you know, we look for unification. I mean, everybody kind of wants to be unified. And I think, you know, we'll have to see how this story sort of evolves. But, you know, it might be interesting to see if Kyle Larson's voice is used for some more positive things in the future. Of course, all eyes are turning to the Bank of America Roval 400 this weekend. The fact that this is an elimination race in the playoffs is pretty wild. Parker, I mean, you have a lot of road course experience. We say Roval, a hybrid, a road course, an oval. How difficult is this for the drivers at this point in the calendar, knowing it's a cut race?
there's nothing easy about the Roval. And before we get into it, I just need to do a quick
Oh, very nice.
That doesn't work. I'm sorry. There's a cap on it. But hey, the Roval is incredibly tough. It is it's a mix of a street course with a traditional road course, and then you have the oval portion. So it's an incredibly tough racetrack. It's a tough place to race. It's a tough place to pass. The grip level is so has so much variation through the whole course. So it's a really tough place just to race, let alone have the pressure of the playoffs. We know the playoff grid is not that enticing right now. It's really going to take someone in that top eight having an issue for Kyle Busch or Austin Dillon or Clint Boyer or Almirall to have a chance at moving forward. We're really going to have to see that. But that brings up a great point, which is there's a high possibility of them having an issue because there's rain on the radar. And I can't think of a place that will be tougher in the rain, because we can race in the rain on road courses, so we will on a Roval, barring some standing water, that will be tougher grip level-wise in the rain than the Roval. It will possibly be one of the most slick, hard to get around, hard to figure out. All the paint around there will be incredibly slick. That will be wild, and I don't think anyone that isn't basically locked in, like a Denny Hamlin, is safe going into this race, because that is going to be incredibly tough.
Yeah, I have to go back, Parker. That's a great analogy and talking about that. And go back to some Zoom interviews we did with the drivers before the playoffs started. And one of our questions to them was, when I say Roval and elimination in the same sentence, what comes to mind? And every one of them were just eyes wide open and shaking their head. It's like, oh, my gosh, let's not even go there yet, because they know of what could possibly happen and how difficult this can be. And what you just pointed out, there is at least a 70% chance of rain on Sunday afternoon at Charlotte and at the Speedway. So we literally could have two races in one, one where part of it's dry and the other part where it's wet. And there's a number of these Cup guys that haven't run on a road course in the rain. They have no idea exactly what to expect. So it could get quite interesting. And when you talk about those drivers that are outside of that top eight right now, you would normally say anywhere that Kyle Busch could go and he could run in the top five in the first couple of stages, gather some points there, and then go get a good top five finish. And that might be enough if someone were to slip up to where he could point his way through there and get into that round of eight. This hasn't been a good track for him whatsoever. And you throw 2020 in there, it seems little or no chance that may possibly happen. So it is going to be so entertaining for us to watch. I can't imagine what those drivers are thinking about right now. And we're talking about more than just ones that sit outside of that top eight. The ones that are right now in there, and they're all at least 21 points to the good at this point in time. But with so many unknowns, it has to be a very unrestful week for them as they try to stay a part of the playoffs.
Parker, your thoughts on, really, Kyle Busch? I think if anyone is the one to watch, he is going to be a headline no matter where he's at on the track, in or out.
Right. DJ, you alluded to it. He hasn't had the success there, but when I think of natural talent, and our producer, Marv, was talking about this on our call just yesterday. He said, when I first came to this sport, people I would ask, who is the most talented driver? We'd all respond, Kyle Busch. So what do I think, where do you see the talent of a driver? It's when you're thrown a ton of variables. And if you're thrown rain, then a drying track, and all the variables that are going to go with that, and the lack of grip, and all the things that are going to change, and how you're going to have to adjust your line. And let me tell you, when you go to a road course in the rain, you know that the line is predominantly going to be offline. It's going to be this odd racing line that you never would see unless it was wet. When you go to the Roval, there's places you're not able to do that. So I have no idea what the racing line is going to be. Everyone is going to be learning on the fly. So I just think if that variable is thrown in there with the wet and the rain, this could be, where Kyle Busch shows up and shows that raw talent and, just does what he does best, which is drive race cars fast.
All right, so we'll have to wait and see. It is crazy when you think of the fact 2020 means the schedule has been sort of flip-flop. Now we're sort of back on course with the playoffs, but still no practice. As you said, Parker, at a course that's difficult on its own right. And, hey, let's throw weather in, too. There's not enough obstacles. Let's go ahead and throw weather in. So it's going to be really entertaining for us. You as the fans certainly benefit. So we'll see you when our coverage begins with the Xfinity Series playoffs on Saturday. and then the Bank of America Roval 400 on Sunday. All right, that's a lot of talking. Parker, you need to grab a Coke because we're sort of worn out, but we'll see you this weekend. Thanks for watching.
Hey, motorsports fans, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit subscribe before you go for all the latest news and highlights across motorsports.